As a result of a rare condition that limits her body movements, Bella Burton has spent a great part of her life in a hospital bed. But she's not alone. For helping her on this rough road, she couldn't have asked for a better companion, a service dog, and a good one, by the way. Born in Woburn, Massachusetts, she lived a normal life with her family until her mother noticed that she was growing very little, and in fact, she was very small for a two-year-old. Since it seemed odd and they didn't know if this was normal, they decided to consult with the doctors to see what was happening with her. But when doctors got to assess Bella's symptoms, they were left clueless as to what the little girl might be suffering from. So they recommended doing a series of genetic tests to discover if the problem was of a deeper nature. Doctors discovered that Bella was one in 200,000 births who suffered from Morquio syndrome, a strange condition that incapacitates the natural body functions from breaking down certain types of sugar chains, and also affects how bones grow and develop. When Bella had turned 11 years old, she relied on wheelchairs and crutches to move around. It had a devastating effect on the girl's happiness and self-esteem, as she wasn't able to play with other children her age. "I'm just like, I don't want this anymore," she told BarkPost in 2016, a dog-centric website. You would think that 9 major surgeries are enough for a lifetime. For Bella, it's probably only the beginning of her life. She had multiple surgeries on her feet and hip, and relying on a crutch and wheelchair worried her parents as she might be losing strength in her legs. Bella's mother, Rachel, explained to the Bark Post how her daughter's life was. Morquio syndrome is a rare progressive disorder, so it affects Bella's mobility. As a result of this conversation, Bella and her mother ended up volunteering at the Service Dog Project, an organization that focuses on training Great Danes as service dogs for the mobility impaired. Although the organization is aimed to help veterans, they also help children and anyone with disorders that affect their mobility or balance. The Service Dog Project organization has at any given time 30 or more dogs in training at the facility, which is located on a 12-acre piece of land in Ipswich, Massachusetts. It was there that Bella met George, a Great Dane so massive that he was perfect for helping anyone with mobility issues. Bella and George became instant friends. One day, Bella climbed up with George and she just started talking to George. Next thing you know, his head was in her lap. "He's just looking up at her like she was the best thing in the whole world," said Megan Kakaris, one of the trainers that work in the organization. For Bella, it was like a revelation moment. She knew right away that if she got a service dog, it would be George. "I could tell he needed me, and I needed him." After a little more than a year doing volunteer work at the Service Dog Project organization, she got her own canine friend. In the beginning, George would sleep in the home during the weekends so that he could make an easy transition. Then in January 2015, George got to go live full-time with Bella and her family. Now she'd always have someone to help her take care of herself. With the help and motivation provided by her new furry friend, Bella regained the confidence to walk again. And boy, she walked. She even learned how to ride a bike. "First time I walked with George, it was amazing," the young girl said to BarkPost. "It was like, I haven't walked in so long and now I get to do it again." "I don't remember the last time I watched my child run through the yard. Seeing her just run was amazing for us," said Rachel to a newspaper in 2015. The family decided that since Bella was doing so good thanks to George, the dog should be rewarded for all the joy he was bringing into their home. The family then contacted the BarkPost website, and they decided that George was due for something special. BarkPost decided to treat George as part of their Dog's Best Day series. The family and dog visited Boston's Fairmont Copley Plaza, and they went to enjoy some human food at the famous Wahlburgers restaurant. After the hotel room and the delicious meal, Bella and George got to play in the snow and do some sledding. After so much exercise, it was obvious that George needed to refuel, so he headed to a special doggy bakery, and they gave him a lot of tasty treats. After returning to their hotel room, Bella and George found it filled with new toys and doggy accessories, plus a note that notified Bella that BarkPost had donated $10,000 to the Service Dog Project in her name, so more people could enjoy the company like the one that she and George shared. No one knows for sure what fate has prepared for Bella. People with Morquio syndrome very often don't get past their 20s, yet there are others in their 40s, and they're still going strong. Bella's condition will be monitored continuously to make sure she has the best life possible. And while this might seem somewhat heartbreaking, the little girl is still enjoying with George as much as she can. "He's the one that made me more independent than I ever could be. He's always there to cheer you up. He's my best friend."